Hello, friends. In a previous post, I was talking about the Akashic field, consciousness field, quantum field, etc. And someone commented that the Akashic field could be the equivalent of the block universe that Einstein described. So I thought I'd explore that with you. There are indeed interesting parallels and potential areas of overlap between the Akashic field and the block universe. Here's the breakdown of the concepts and how they may relate. So the Akashic field is rooted in ancient Hindu philosophy and later developed in Western esoteric traditions, notably theosophy. It is described as a cosmic library or universal record of all events, thoughts, emotions, and possibilities from the past, present, and future. It's seen as the underlying fabric of existence. In other words, it's a consciousness field. Some believe it's possible to access the Akashic field through various meditative techniques, altered states, or psychic means. I personally feel that I access it for ideas that are not mine, but that seem revelatory. What about the block universe? That's a concept in physics, particularly in Einstein's theory of special relativity. And it views the universe as a four-dimensional block where time is laid out similar to spatial dimensions. Past, present, and future are equally real and coexist, in which case free will might be an illusion in this framework. I don't think it is. It depends on your state of consciousness, because as we expand states of consciousness, then there's more freedom. In any case, the block universe is a theoretical model, not something directly expressed. We experience it through our subjective perception of time as a flowing sequence of events. The point of connection here is that both the Akashic field and the block universe point to a concept of existence where everything that ever happened or could happen is already present in some sense in a field of potentiality. The idea that all events and possibilities leave a permanent imprint or record resonates with both concepts. Both views challenge our conventional understanding of time as a purely linear progression. Both concepts, like the Akashic field and the implications of the block universe, hint at the possibility that information might exist in a way that transcends our usual notions of space and time, suggesting to a non-local aspect to reality. Of course, there are key differences. The Akashic field is primarily a concept tied to spirituality and consciousness, and the Akashic field often incorporates the idea of a consciousness being fundamental, in fact, as the ontological primitive of the universe, while the block universe doesn't necessarily require a conscious observer. The Akashic field is believed by some to be accessible, as I said, through altered states, and the block universe remains a theoretical concept beyond direct experience. So whether the Akashic field or the block universe model ultimately describe the same fundamental reality is an open question, according to experts, that blend science, philosophy, and spirituality. They provide a fascinating lens to explore the nature of time, existence, and the interconnectedness of all things. So where do I stand on this? I think that the block universe described objectively through theoretical physics is still described as a mathematical concept in consciousness. And you can't have an observed without an observer. The two are entangled. So I think the block universe is a concept in theoretical physics that does support the Akashic field. And I believe we have access to it as a theoretical construct mathematically, but as a practical experience through transcendence of the senses. Let me know if, and this leads to extraordinary conclusions, extrasensory perception, non-local dormant potential, seeing the past, future, psychic abilities, and so forth. Let me know your thoughts on this.